Oracle Planning Cloud provides access to the Groovy scripting language. Groovy allows you to create context-specific, dynamic business rules that can dramatically improve the performance of calculations and data movement in your application. Similar to business rules, you create Groovy Rules in Calculation Manager. You launch Groovy Rules from any place a business rule can be run. For technical reference on designing Groovy Rules, see the Java API reference for Oracle Enterprise Performance Management Cloud Groovy Rules on the Cloud Help Center. The Java API reference includes examples that demonstrate the syntax and power of the EPM Groovy object model. In this series of tutorials, you'll learn design best practices on how to use Groovy Rules to perform focused data movement and smart calculations on planning data. In this tutorial, we'll show you best practices on how you can use Groovy Rules to calculate incrementally loaded data in data management. I'll load 6 rows of employee data to the following data point of view: January, FY16 for the period and year, current for scenario, BU version 1 for version, US dollars for currency, and no entity. The Data Management Incremental File Adapter feature enables you to compare a source data file with a prior version of the source data file and identify new or changed records and then load only to that data set. I'll set up a data load that uses the incremental file adapter and associate a Groovy rule that calculates employee bonus only on records with salary changes. First, I'll define a data source that uses the incremental file adapter and associate a data file that will serve as a template for the header row. The data source is named after the file name. Here are the contents of my template file. Here is the required header row. Next, I'll create an import format. For source, I'll select the data source I registered. For file type, I'll select the limited and all data types. The target is set to my application. After the initial save, I'll map source and target dimensions. Then, save again. Next, I'll create a location using my import format and USD as the functional currency. Make sure you have period and category mappings defined. Before adding any mappings, verify that you selected the correct location POV. Now, I'll enter data load mappings for all of my dimensions. With mappings in place, I can create my data load rule. Again, verify that you selected the correct location POV. I'll name my data load rule EMP_data, accept the default category selected, and set the target plan type to plan 2. I'll go to target options to verify that the load method is set to all data types with security, and purge data files is set to no. By setting this option, I can download and view a data file that contains the data records that were imported or exported using my data load rule. For custom options, I'll leave all entry fields blank. I'll return to source filters and associate my initial data file. I'll upload my data file to the inbox and select it. Then, I'll return to target options and associate my Groovy rule. I'll save my data load rule. Before running the data load rule, let's take a look at my Groovy rule. This Groovy rule calculates an employee's bonus when there are changes to salary. The Groovy rule starts with an if statement that determines if there is a data value provider for the current operation. The current operation may either be a grid operation where it runs after data is saved on a form, or a data load using data management. In this case, we are running the Groovy rule after a data load in data management. This section defines sets to capture unique scenarios, versions, entities, periods, years, currencies, and employees. This section captures whether the changes were made to the salary account of a record. If no changes were determined, a message is displayed and no further action is made. If there were salary changes to a record, an S-based calc script is run to calculate the employee's bonus based on this formula. When the calculation completes, this message is displayed. Now, I'll go back to data management and assign my Groovy business rule to my data load rule in my target application. My target application was created when I first created my EPBCS application. On the Business Rules tab, I'll add an entry and assign my Groovy rule to the data load rule I created. Now, I'll run my data load rule. Click Refresh to see the updated state of the data load. The status displays a green check mark when successful. I'll open my form to verify the data load. Data loaded successfully. Next, I'll run the rule using a data file that contains modified data. In Data Management, I'll upload a new source file for my data load rule. Notice that the last process ID is set to 181. I'll save my changes, then run the data load rule. When I click refresh, the last process ID is updated. The run status displays a green check mark. Because I set the purge data file option to no, I can download and view a data file that contains the data records that were imported or exported using my data load rule. I'll download the data file that matches the last process ID. The data file contains only the modified records, which were loaded into my application. Consequently, the Groovy rule that calculates employee bonus would run against the changed records. I'll open the form to verify. Here are the updated records. The bonus was calculated based on the modified data. In this tutorial, you saw best practices in using Groovy rules to calculate incrementally loaded data in data management. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.